to take my phone out. If he does something to me, you know who to call. If he says yes, then we'll just throw it in. It should be good. All right, let's go see what happens. Well, first off, so I never do this stuff. Usually my management company takes care of everything, but we've got this tenant that has been a total pain in the butt. And I didn't really know about it till just recently because we're having to do a full eviction. And anytime we need to do a full eviction, that means that I have to go in and sign some papers because the owner has to sign them so that we can go through with the eviction. And so I started asking questions about what's going on. And I guess this guy has been caught with drugs down in the basement. We've had complaints upstairs of their like being straight up orgies in the basement. There have been tons of complaints from the tenants that aren't even ours, that are next door, that tons of crazy parties have happened and then that they're leaving crap out in the neighbor's yard. There have just been complaint after complaint. The frustrating thing is the first 6 months, I guess they were perfect tenants, but then for the last 4 months, they have been horrendous. The beginning, the first of the last 4 months, they still paid a portion of rent, but then after that point, they just completely stopped paying rent. They were stringing us along, saying that they had X, Y, and Z that was coming in. And really, I've never seen someone manipulate my management company so well. Usually, if they have someone that, you know, it isn't going well with, they right away are able to get people out and say, look, we're going to go down the eviction process, yada, yada. And they either get them to pay and work things out, or they go and go through the process and get them kicked out quick. But somehow this tenant has managed to stay in the property for now 4 months while getting free rent, while doing all of this other garbage. And finally, the management company went in, got them served. We had court today that I decided to go to just so I could kind of see, because I'd never been to an eviction. We've had them before, but I wanted to go and be a part of the process. So we went through the whole eviction. We went through all the garbage, and this tenant is having the cops show up to their place 2 days from now to get them out of the property. So we told them, look, this is it. You've got 2 days to go out peacefully, or they know the cops are showing up. The court case is closed. It's all good to go. And now we just need to get them out of the property. So we went through this whole process with all of this different garbage, and it's kind of been frustrating because obviously I've lost money, and for me it hasn't been that frustrating because my management company's been taking care of it, but it's still frustrating that we haven't been getting paid. I haven't been acting as the landlord because I have a management company that has been dealing with them, dealing with the issues, talking to them, doing all that. So they don't really know me, but I'm hoping I can go and sell them on letting us go and sit down and get their side of the story and kind of just do an interview. So we're gonna go see if we can pull it off. I don't know if it's actually gonna happen, but I figured why not go and try and knock on their door, see what happens, even though they just had the court case this morning and they're getting evicted in 2 days. Hopefully we can go in and sit down with them and kind of see their side of the story and how they feel they're justified to live in a place for 4 months without paying rent and doing all of this other garbage. So we're gonna go see what happens. I'm not really that nervous. I mean, you always, anytime you knock on someone's door, and obviously I've knocked on thousands of doors, the only thing that I'm a little nervous about is we know there's been drugs, and so I don't wanna show up and have some crazy person with a knife or a gun or something like that. But I think the odds of that happening are low, just because that doesn't happen very often. So we're gonna see what happens. we're driving over there right now to see what happens. So yeah, my videographer, I can tell, was a little nervous that you weren't gonna be there with us. So we're gonna see what happens. Oh, hey Jace, in like 60 seconds, can you give us a rundown of all of the crap, I guess, that you've had to deal with these tenants over the last couple months?
Tenants decide not to pay rent. That's pretty standard stuff. And tenants, little things come in, you scrape out a mold off the ceiling, you paint the whole bathroom, you clean the drains or sinks, and you get everything running perfectly. You get a brand new water heater put in, you fix the line in the laundry room because it's not venting right, and then they still don't pay rent. Then you have neighbors move out upstairs because of the noise and the orgy parties going on downstairs. and then you find out upstairs they've been in the house, they took some food out, and they stole the water pipes from underneath the kitchen sink.
I forgot about that.
For some reason, I don't know why, but someone stole all the pipes, and they are the ones that had the access to the door. Then their power gets shut off because of lack of payment on that side. So they bust the door in between the two apartments and plug their cord into the outlet inside the upstairs unit apartment.
I forgot they were stealing electricity, too.
Yeah. Okay, we could press charges for burglary because they are still a tower. Instead of making an ultimatum, they won't press charges if you move out in the next 7 days. Then the cops show up on their own because they see this activity. They find marijuana downstairs, take a bag, a giant bag full and a brown stack of marijuana and, like, paraphernalia. And then they tell us we're going to pay because we have our tax return coming in. It's like $3,000. We're going to get all paid up. We're going to be good. So we wait another week or two for them to come in. We'd rather get the money and then evict them than not get the money. Boom, this doesn't happen. And now we're back to where we're at right now. another court case. So it's been all kinds of fun at that apartment.
Thanks so much, man. Enjoy the night with your family knowing you're just about done with it. With all of this, we still have to go through the whole process to get them evicted. And that's one thing that's super frustrating about evictions. You know, they really try to give the tenant the, I guess, advantage in these situations just to make sure they're not being taken advantage of by landlords. But now we're out a ton of money. If we can get inside, we're going to find that there are tons of holes, tons of broken things. In court today, he complained about the fridge being broken, and it's like, the fridge is probably broken because of you, so we're gonna have a broken fridge. Just a nightmare of different issues that Jace has had to deal with. And again, usually I don't deal with this stuff, and that's what's so nice about having a management company. But when I heard how crazy this tenant was and this situation was, I thought, man, there's no way we can't go and at least record the situation so that people can see like a worst case scenario. And so this last month we had our best month ever with rents because we just had another rent increase on everything, and we didn't have any other issues with people paying this month other than this one tenant. So overall, 63 doors, having one that ends up being bad really isn't that bad. I mean, I think people think of this as the worst case scenario, but when you've got a management company that's done things well, and this is your one bad one with a bunch of good ones, it really isn't that big of a deal. However, it is gonna be super interesting to see if we can interview them, get their perspective, and just kind of see what happens. So the other thing that's really interesting is this is the lowest end unit that I currently rent out. And so it's just a one bedroom apartment. The thing that's so sad, I don't have before pictures, but we had this place looking incredible. Like brand new carpets, nice paint, very clean kitchen. And I'm hoping we can get inside to show you, because from what Jace has said, the place is a total mess and a total nightmare. And that's what people don't realize. I mean, not getting rents for a month is one thing, but with an eviction, usually you're dealing with just a destroyed apartment, super upset people that don't care about it and are willing to take whatever you do. And the other thing that's really discouraging that I don't think people realize is, as a landlord, we can go and we can kick them out, which is awesome because then we can clean it up and get someone else in there. But this is after not getting paid for a while, and there's no way we're gonna get that money. I mean, yeah, we can turn it in and go after them, but if people don't have money, they don't have money. And so you're never gonna see that money again. And so there's still stuff that we can try and do, but it's a pain because now we've got added legal fees, we've got all of these other things. We're probably not gonna see a dime, but I think people still view us as maybe a savage for kicking someone on the street when we've tried so hard to be patient and do things the right way. So that's why, though, I think it'll be interesting when we go to talk to them. My game plan is to go up and say, all right, here's the deal. I know you're in court today. I know things were rough. However, I'm the owner, and I want to just check up that Jace has been doing his job correctly, and I was hoping that we could do an interview just to get your perspective. And so then I'll ask for permission to use this for training so that, one, I can do my job better in the future, Jace can do his job better in the future, and most importantly, so that we can put the interview on YouTube so that people can see how crazy an eviction can be.
Like, what are things legally that they do, your tenants, that you can immediately go and evict them?
So it's interesting because evicting someone for doing a bunch of crap is actually a lot harder if they're still paying rent. The easiest way to get an eviction is if people are just not paying. Now, obviously, if there are like large criminal charges, I would imagine that it wouldn't be too hard to get them out. However, I'm not confident in that. I do know we've had pretty good luck getting through the eviction process because they'll show up and the main question that they're asked is, well, have you paid your rent? Now, if they can show receipts that they've fixed a ton of stuff because we weren't doing our job, then it gets kind of tricky because I think the judge a lot of times might say, hey, maybe we should let them stay in here because the landlord's been doing a terrible job and they've had to spend all this money they shouldn't have. And so if you're ever getting evicted and you're in that situation because your landlord is crappy, make sure you bring your receipts, make sure you bring proof, bring pictures, because that's the one situation where if they bring proof that, hey, we did a terrible job and that's why they didn't pay, then it can get a little iffy. But if we've done our job right and they're just not paying their rent, it should be pretty easy to get them out. I'm hoping, though, with everything that happened today in court, that they just leave before we have to actually send the cops there. And that's usually what people do. I mean, once you have the court case and they're like, all right, cops are coming on Monday, it's like, okay, maybe we'll just leave. And so after talking to them today, from everything I've heard from Jace, we're hoping they'll be gone before we have to get to that point. And that's why I thought we could go over and just say, hey, we know you're getting out. We know you've gone through this. Will you give us the opportunity to interview you and just get your side of things? And we'll see. I mean, if push comes to shove and they're like, no, we don't want to let you in, I know these people are hurting for money, so I might throw them like 50 or 100 bucks and just say, come on, just let me go now so that we can have this for the video, because I'm sure the apartment is just trashed and I really want people to see kind of what it's like dealing with this kind of a situation. Not because I want to scare you away from investing, but because this crap does happen, and as long as you're just planning on the crap happening, then it's all good. So, best case scenario, I feel like we get there. I kind of hit it off with the guy, even though he's pissed that we're kicking him out of his place. And we can pull the chairs out of the back of my truck and sit in front of his property and just have like a nice little interview. Just get his side of things. Worst case scenario, there's like the worst case that we just don't get in and he comes and yells or he just doesn't answer at all. Or there's the really worst case scenario, which, I mean, that's just up to your imagination, which I'm hoping nothing like that will happen.
Can we get him like a Coke or something? Maybe.
I don't know. Probably not a bad idea. A love note. We're like a mile away from the property. We're going to go knock on this guy's door. See if we can get him to answer and agree to an interview, even though we've been trying to kick him out of his apartment for the last 3-4 months, and he had his eviction trial today, and the judge already said that we have the right to evict him, and we said that we would send the cops in 2 days to go and pull him forcibly out of the apartment if he doesn't have everything out. And so I got this idea that, hey, let's go and see if we can interview him and just get his perspective. Even though he's probably heated and upset about the whole situation, I want to get his side of things, and we're going to go knock on his door and see if we can get him calmed down enough to have an interview with us and hopefully get inside this property that's totally been destroyed by this crazy druggy guy. So we're going to see what happens, and we're literally like a block away. Here, let's just keep it rolling.
Yeah.
And hop out here and get in. Ready to roll? So it's going to be the basement unit. Hello, hello. Is anybody here? Hey guys, we're coming in. We just wanted to make sure no one was here. Is anyone here? They literally have been stealing electricity, and I guess they must just keep plugging it in when nobody's looking. So it's weird because the water was left on, and I have no idea why. So one of the things they're complaining about is the stairs, which we need to fix them anyways, but so this is like the mess that they've left out right now. I think they're trying to move out. Yeah, it was just open right when we got here, and it looks like nobody's there. Hello, is anyone here? All right, we're coming in. We're not coming in. Oh, I don't want to go in. I don't think we can, but kind of see it's just a freaking mess, holes in the wall. So both doors are open and I've yelled down in it. They're saying like no one's there. Would I be allowed to go in? I don't know. I guess there's a chance someone could be downstairs, but I know they have kids and it looks like no one is here. No one was responsive or anything. Okay, cool. Well, let me see if we can pull that off. So that's my dad. He's a lawyer here in Idaho, and he thinks we could call the cops and have them come. Just because no one's answering the door, it's a safety concern to leave both the doors open, especially when we just did the eviction, the water was running. So I just called Jace. He said we could do, like he's done it before, where if no one's answered for a while, you can do like a wellness check and call the cops and they'll just come, they'll knock on the door. If no one's there, then you can open the door and you can go in just to make sure like no one's dead in there or something. Dude, there's so much weird stuff that you'd have to pay for. Like, to serve them, you can pay the police to serve them, but they go, they knock the door. If they're not there, you pay $50 and that's your shot. Like, that's it. So my dad has a guy as a lawyer, because he has to serve people all the time, that's like this, you know, rough dude, and that's all he does is serve people for $50, but he actually makes sure that they get served. That's what he has to do to get paid. So using someone like that goes better, but there's just so many weird rules to protect tenants, and it's just a total nightmare, and that's why you can get stranded forever trying to get through the process. Because even now, we've got like the eviction notice, but what's interesting is even with the eviction notice, and or not the eviction notice, but like we can go and evict them now. If you evict them and they haven't moved out, you've got to pay for moving company to come get rid of the crap. You've got to pay for storage units to keep the crap until they find a new place. You've got to pay for all kinds of garbage. And so even though they're way back on rents, we have to pay a court fee of $169 for each of them to file it. And then after all of that, we'd have to pay to store their stuff if we can't just coerce them into leaving on their own before we go through the whole eviction, moving trucks, changing the keys, all of that garbage. So you really hope that you can find a way to scare them enough to just get them out on their own. Because literally, if they play their cards right and people hide so that they don't get served, like we had an issue with them doing, I mean, you could live in a place forever just by continuing to dodge. Now, I mean, there's a chance eventually you're going to get caught. It's hard, and the life you live would suck. But if you have someone that your arrangement is, look, I'll pay you $50 as long as you actually serve them, you can negotiate someone on the side. It just has to be a third party person that isn't like a main witness in the issue. So Jace couldn't go serve them. He had to have someone with him that could be the person to serve them, and then wait until they were here and make sure the person's there to get them served. This is a total nightmare, but you see stories over in like Europe or other places where they lean way further towards helping out the tenants. You got people that have been living for free. I've heard stories, and maybe they're not true, but literally years, where they just find ways to stay in because of the rules there. So I really like, I'm tempted to go just walk in, but then if we get like stabbed or shot or they freak out, and if he comes in from behind and we're down in his place and he knows he had 2 days to get out, like there's always that risk that we piss him off. I feel like if we call the cops, it would be like, catchy for YouTube, but I didn't want something like that. I really wanted to be able to sit down and talk with them and just get their perspective of things. So I think we let it go and we just try and come back tomorrow before they're supposed to be out and just say, look, we really want your perspective. We want your side of things. We want to hear your experience, what your frustrations were, all of that. And then we can come back and catch them then. Sound good? Before we do that though, let's go walk around the property and see all the crap we can see from the outside. So first off, you can see they're literally stealing electricity from the upstairs tenant. And they've been complaining about it forever, but they just keep coming and plugging it back in. This is ridiculous. I want to see if there's someone we could get a hold of. Oh, dude. That's the worst thing when you have a property and it smells like a property that you're like, oh, I'm in the right place because I'm going to get a killer deal on this property because of how it smells. And now my property smells that way. So, So I think that was the other broken window. When I got here, they literally just had the water running. And then they've got all of this garbage back here. All of the windows have been broken by them. And in the eviction hearing, they were complaining about how we haven't come to fix the broken windows that they've broken while being on drugs in the process of going through not paying their rent. So it's like, come on. The other thing, we don't own these garages. They're owned by the tenant or an owner of a building over here. With all of this crap here, we got a super pissed off call from the owners there that came and complained. They found my information and called me up and they're like, hey, your property looks like crap. And we're like, well, it just is like this now because we literally are trying to get the tenants out and it's their garbage and supposedly they're moving. But I guess Jace said it's been like this for a while. So you just asked me what can you do to prevent a situation like this. And the truth is just try and find good tenants. I mean, if you end up with crappy tenants, you just got to move as quick as you can to get them out. Because the longer you let them get away with crap, the more of a mess it becomes. And so it's all about picking good tenants and having good processes. And my management company does an awesome job, but you still miss the mark every once in a while, and then you've got to deal with this nightmare. I think anyone that owns a larger number of properties at some point is going to have to deal with an eviction. It's just part of the game. Especially, well, it really doesn't matter. I mean, even on some of the higher-end properties, you still get bums in there that can't afford to pay. The difference, though, is sometimes you'll get tenants like this that literally think they're in the wrong, that you're trying to kick them out when they haven't paid for months. Where there are other people where some of our past evictions, they literally just show up and they're like, yeah, I didn't pay rent. I'm sorry, I'm leaving. Like, that's it. And a lot of times it doesn't even get to that point because why would they let it get to that point? They know they're not paying and so they just leave. But this one's been a freaking nightmare. All right. Okay,
well.
Okay, till next time. What's going on, guys? We are back at our second attempt to try and snag the tenants at this eviction to hopefully get an interview and get them convinced to leave the property. Just so you understand the situation, an eviction is a total nightmare because even though we've gone in, we've served him, we've got him in a situation where we can evict him today if we wanted to, the issue is we tried to serve the girlfriend who's also on the lease. And we didn't get to her until after the time period because you have to serve them at least 5 days before the court appearance. So her court appearance isn't until this upcoming Friday where he already had his. We already have permission to do an eviction with him. But if we go through that whole process, get the cops here, do it, and evict him, the thing is she still has the right to stay in there. So it would be a total nightmare because he could probably just come back and paying for the whole process just wouldn't be worth it. Now, if we end up having to do the full-on eviction, that means we have to pay movers. That means we have to have a place to store their crap. We have to get the cops out here. We have to go through that whole process. So my goal is to hopefully either fear tactic them out or try and find a situation where I can bribe them out just so we don't have to go through that whole mess. Because her court appearance isn't until this upcoming Friday, and it sounds like they know we're kind of up against the wall with waiting until we can go and get that for her, which we'll be able to do, but I want to avoid all of that, and so I'm hoping meeting up with them, I'll be able to, one, interview them, because it'd be fascinating to interview someone who's screwed us out of all of this money and is literally staying in the property as long as they can, even though they know they shouldn't be there. So we want to get that interview, but two, I'm hoping after I have the interview, I can get buddy-buddy with them and I can work out some situation to just get them out of the property so we don't have to go through that. Now, my management company has been trying to do this and they said, Chandler, it's a total loss. We're going to have to go through the eviction. We've tried everything, but I figure why not come in, play the owner card and see if we can't figure something else out. And if nothing else, we'll get kind of a crazy, I guess, interaction or hopefully interview. So we're gonna see what happens, and I'm hoping we can catch them this time, because if we don't catch them this time, I'm probably gonna give up and just let them go through the eviction, and maybe we'll go record that if we have time, maybe not, but we're gonna go see what happens. So we might be out of luck, but I think these might be their kids running around. So okay, I'm gonna roll. It's Chandler. Chandler, the owner of the property.
What's going on?
Just want to see what the deal is, man.
Oh, just getting everything packed up and shit for them. That's about it.
Okay. When do you guys think you'll be out?
Shit, as soon as we get everything packed up, we got to, supposed to get a U-Haul. I got to get my ID today.
Okay.
So I pick up some more money and shit. And then, get a U-Haul. As soon as we get everything packed up, we'll be out.
Okay. Do you have, like, a time frame? Because I know you agreed you'd give us 2 days. Like, I'm trying to be a reasonable man, but, like, you got to understand.
See, trying to get everything situated. All my shit is gone. This is the rest of her shit, so you ain't waiting for me no more. That's okay. It. All my shit been gone.
Sounds good. Okay.
Yeah, my shit been gone.
So, is she here? Like, should I talk to her about it, or?
She said she'll try to be done by tomorrow evening.
Tomorrow evening. Okay. So, now I have a funny request for you. Okay? So, you know, I own the property. I own a couple different properties, and I want to, first off, make sure that Jace has been doing his job right with you guys. I know you brought up a lot of complaints, which I hate to hear. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it's not like it's like rookie mistakes, basically. Not like Jace is a bad dude or anything.
Yeah.
He's an awesome guy, to be honest. He's awesome. I like him. But as a landlord,
just didn't really cut it in a lot of ways, huh?
If it's his first time, I guess you can't really judge off of that. So.
Yeah. Well, can I ask you the question I was going to ask? I want this to be like a learning experience for Jace, but also I train people on dealing with rental properties, going through all that, and I'm pretty new to it. I mean, I've been doing it 5-6 years, but not like 15, 20 years.
Yeah.
I want to get like a tenant's perspective on this, because obviously this situation sucks for both of us.
Yeah.
We both know that. Would you allow us to do like a 5-minute interview to just get your side, some of the complaints that you had, some of the issues you have, so we can ask you? Would you care if we do that?
Yeah, I don't want to put my
You're not putting Jace under the bus at all.
You see what I'm saying?
Like, yeah. No, that's the thing. Jace, dude, I love Jace. Me and him are super tight. We're both learning with it.
Okay,
with a situation like this, I want to get a perspective so we can be like, oh, we could have done this different. We could have done this different. Jace isn't going to get in trouble. He's not going to lose his job. Okay, I asked him for permission. He's like, yeah, might as well learn, because maybe I didn't get the right perspective. Yeah. Maybe I didn't understand.
She's been buying houses for like 15, 20 years. And I'm seeing how her, same way y'all started, that's the same way she started.
Yeah.
Then she just gradually just came up with her own formula. It's like raising kids. You got the same program, you just got to do the approach differently.
Yeah. I've got a guy to record it in my truck. Would you have 5 minutes? I could just interview you, ask questions about some of the issues, some of the things we could have done different, all that stuff.
Yeah, let me give you some shoes on.
Okay, awesome. I'll set up some chairs.
Okay.
All right, so he just agreed to do an interview. I said kind of for training purposes, so we're going to set up chairs and just ask him and see how this goes. And then I'm probably gonna get it heated up because I'm gonna go at him a little bit. So we'll see what happens.
we can get out of here. I can get all that shit fixed up for you, bro. That's no problem. You
know, well, maybe what we'll do.
Hey, how you doing?
This is Tanner, my videographer. Okay, well, first off, thank you for being willing to do this. I was telling you earlier, I know these situations are uncomfortable because obviously we're going through our first, like, full all the way eviction. I mean, we've had times where we've had a threat in it or we've gotten pretty far, but it's never gotten this far. And I know, like, the other day in the court situation, that's uncomfortable for both of us. I know both parties have different opinions, and so I want to do this video once we can get perspective on your experience, what we could have done different, and then just kind of understanding why things have gone the way they have. So first off, the management company, give me your input on, like, how you felt about Jace and what he's done this far.
Jace, to me, okay, so we started out with no window in the living room. And he's like, you just put a trash bag over and tape it. I was like, cool, you know what I mean?
So the window was broken from day one?
Yeah, the living room window over here. And I was like, okay, cool, he's cool, whatever, you know, because the trash bag thing. But, you know, after a while, he's like, oh, it should be here in, like, 9 weeks. And then after a while, he's like, I know it's mine, sorry. But after a while, he's like, oh, it should be here next month. It's on order, blah, blah, blah. And then he just kept giving us excuses. And just like a couple months ago, he had somebody come in and put a temporary window in. And then he said, he's going to have to order the window, so it's going to be here in about 9 to 12 weeks. And I said, really? That was supposed to be ordered like a year ago. You know what I mean? And I'm like, that's kind of messed up. But, and then like, every time I asked him to do something, he'd say he's showing up and never does. And then I'm like, okay, so I put in that the kitchen pipe was messed up on the rental supporter, our portal thingy. Yeah, and so they finally said that a technician will be here this day, and it was Jace. But and it was Thanksgiving, and I had no running water in my kitchen. Like, I was running back and forth from the bathtub to the kitchen, washing dishes on Thanksgiving. It was and I went to bed. I didn't even take the turkey out. I was like, it. And I went to bed. And I texted Jace and gave him a piece of my mind. But, and he's a flake. And then he doesn't, like, if he wants something, you need to ask for it and you need to get it. You know what I mean? Like, no matter what it is. So, and he doesn't communicate very well. And so then, like, we're stuck at this point. Well, you didn't tell me this and I didn't tell you this. So we're both stuck in the, like, what the place? You know what I mean? And it's like, confusing, and that just makes it harder for everybody.
I don't think one time I don't believe he didn't communicate with, like, his wife, because for some reason we was what, a day or two, something late for the late fees. It was something like that.
The first time.
Oh yeah,
we were ever late.
Yeah, I forget about that. Whatever. And he was like, we paid him. He was like, oh, we just waited late fees. It was like a day or two, or whatever. I'm like, all right, don't people do that. I mean, so then the next following month, we get hit with the same late fee that was supposed to be waived. And his wife was like, yo, you gotta pay
$50 late fee for the previous month. And then Jace was like, just pay half of it. You know what I mean? Kind of, I feel like that was a compromise.
And it shouldn't have been a compromise. He said, just told his wife I already waived it.
Yeah.
I don't care if you if y'all bumped heads, okay, that's cool. We bump heads all the time, but I still gotta honor what I said to you.
Mm-hmm.
If I said, I'm not going to charge you, then that's, I don't care who say what. Wife, I don't care.
Yeah.
I'm not going to charge you.
Yeah, so you guys were late on the rent, and then Jace told you one thing, but she told you something.
Well, we were late. So for the $50 late fee, he said, well, we'll just waive it because it's our first time, you know? And I'm like, hey, it's going to be a couple days. I just was a problem with my bank. And so then, like, this was like
September,
the end of last year, yeah. And we had been here for almost a year. I was like, dude, we've been late one time. This is our first time ever. You know what I mean? And because she was all talking about some crazy crap on the email. And I'm like, dude, like, Jace said that fee was waived. I don't understand why I owe 50 for last month, you know? And then so I texted Jace, like, what the hell is going on? And he's all, we'll just pay 25 of it and then we can call it good. I said, wow, okay. You know what I mean? And then, like, damn it. I was thinking something else too and I forgot. Dig it. You made me forget.
So other than those things, like, seems like the windows, the late fee confusion, was there anything else that they did that was bad, or overall were you pretty happy with everything else?
You know, he's actually been really working with me, and he's like, I pictured you as some old dude, you know what I mean? Like, for real, because he's all, the owner's on my ass, blah, 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 and I'm like, and he's all young, and he's all, basically saying, that, he just couldn't hold you off anymore or some shit. And I'm picturing some old guy that, you know, yeah, gets pissed about kids on his lawn and shit. And so it's like,
well, yeah, I mean, just so you know our perspective, like, I have a loan on this property. Okay. So every month I don't get paid. Yeah. I'm paying out of my account for something that I was supposed to, like, you know, yeah, what I mean? I, like, I'm working too. It's hard to, yeah, especially when it gets like 3-4 months worth of paying another loan that I wasn't planning on.
I really feel as though he should have renewed the lease. I don't understand why the lease.
Since July. That's what I was going to say. Mm-hmm. Since last July.
So in the lease, it just goes month to month.
Okay, but shouldn't it be like
dated? I think the biggest reason, Jace, just you guys understand the perspective, because you were late on rent once the lease ended, mm-hmm, he wasn't confident he wanted to do anything more than month to month.
That's understandable.
Because he wanted to be able to say, look, you guys get out. We want someone else in because we want someone that can pay everything.
Then I feel as though, like, he should have said that instead of telling us. See, the confusion became is when he told us, oh, I just got to get the paperwork. Meaning, if so I asked you for a lease, meaning you're giving me a lease.
And if I just got to get the paperwork. Time, I could have been found a place and we could have been out and we wouldn't have ever had this problem. We might have still owed a little bit. But like I said, he's been real understanding about a lot of things. You know what I mean? And I mean, obviously the fighting, you know, I'm sure you've heard about it. But he, he's been real understanding and stuff, like I said. And he said something about we wouldn't have to pay what we owe and stuff. And I said, either way, I'm going to pay it back. You know what I mean? Yeah. Even if it's slow as I'm going to pay it back. Yeah, you know what I mean?
So just for...
I have no debt. Nowhere.
Yeah. So just for clarity, I mean, so you guys right now, I think you haven't paid, ends up being about 3 or 4 months worth.
Yeah, it's almost, it's probably over two. It's over $2,000. I know that.
Yeah. So with that, I mean, it hasn't had any payments in the last little bit. Like, have you guys been planning on paying that eventually, or what was kind of your situation?
He kind of just, like, stopped talking to us. And I understand that the phone number thing, but I always text him with my new number, and it changes a lot. That's my fault, but whatever.
But he always had an updated number for both of us.
And the number that I've texted him off before, it's a text now number, so I've had that for months, like almost a year. And he's had that number the whole time, and I've called him off of it. Like, and so, I don't know, he's been kind of just stopped talking to us. And so it's like, okay, well, if you're not going to come fix anything, I'm not going to pay him rent, you know what I mean? And then, like, because everybody was telling me, dude, why are you still paying rent, blah blah blah, if your landlord hasn't done this to show up or whatever, blah blah blah, blah. You know what I mean? I was like, I didn't know I could do that, you know what I mean, like, not pay rent to see if it'll get over here to do something. And like, I'm thinking Jace handles all this, and we're like, nah, they gotta be the owners, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. He has to be, if he's being this lenient or whatever, you know. I don't know your situation or whatever, but like I said, I pictured you as like parents or something, but he's like, he just made it real confusing.
The thing I don't like about people is that if you really want something, just be straight up forward and honest with it. Mm-hmm. I mean,
yeah, so I think, I mean, just...
I mean, no, you really don't. I think you don't.
Okay.
Well, it's really hard, and you can see it in somebody's eyes. It's really hard to play dumb. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You can't play dumb and don't think another smart person is realizing that you're smart as f*** and you're playing dumb right now. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes. Yeah,
so it's like...
So just so we're real, I mean, let's get some perspective. Let's say you've got a tenant in a building. Mm-hmm. They haven't paid rent for a month or two. Yeah. Do you think you would want to do anything to fix the building at that point?
Kind of. Yes, I would, because it's still my mother f- property.
Right.
I don't give a about what they do. At the end of the day, I still got to, when they get out, guess what I got to do any motherfucking way? Might as well knock it out the way so they won't have any problems or issues, especially if it was problems and issues in the beginning that was not solved. We never said anything about the hailstorm, about the fucking window that wasn't there, that damaged over $1,300 of our
Yeah.
Why? Because the window wasn't fixed. So you motherfucking right. Fix your You know what I mean? If you like somebody, I mean, on some real if would have got fixed on time, I'd have paid you on time.
Cassie.
If I wasn't struggling with a sweat closet that mildewed out, damn near $800 worth of clothes. Now, this is $1,300 plus $8. You get what I'm talking about?
Yeah, so let me
and
ask
then,
you this.
No. You want to get perspective. So the perspective is we've told your landlord that our broke. We want to be real. I've told him several times about different little. I told him something about the black mold for like 4 months.
And I have kids, so like the black mold took him like 8 months. No, longer than that. It took him like, he didn't even do the black mold till after the window.
And then like, you got a percent.
And we had to clean it. Six, and he came and painted it.
Actually, it was for 8 months. Never been late. And you ain't came and fixed a thing. And we out there near close to $3,000 worth of. You motherfucking right, you ain't getting paid.
And I
why? Because you're not taking care of your fucking property, bro. Real talk. It's not about just money.
Calm down, dude.
No, motherfuckers live here. Motherfuckers invest in families here. Motherfuckers want to do one day do it the right way. You're not doing it the right way, bro.
This is all for
you're being a slumlord. You look at that top, it's still fucked off.
What
all
is?
All in all, this house is a piece of just to keep it real with you. You have no driveway, none. You really have no yard space, none. You have a next door neighbor that cries if a kid spits on his shelters that he don't even use. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Would you
mind? You got windows that have been there since when? Who even has wooden windows anymore, bro? No one. This house is nowhere near up to code. You see right here? Whoever did this the first time it off.
And my friend right here tried to sue you guys or whatever. She broke her ankle on that.
Whoever did this the first time you off. You're buying bums. I offered your landlord to cover a debt that I shouldn't even have to fucking cover because I ain't covering shit that I lost. Nothing.
Yeah. Would you mind
showing? To fix this motherfucker and kill the debt that we owed you. And at the end of the day, I would have fixed this motherfucker perfect. Both of them. And guess what? I'm still out $2,500.
He ain't coming to show. He's just letting me know.
Well, yeah.
Still out $2,500, bro.
So we're gonna do it.
Yeah. Do you want to? Could we see? Like, I'd love. Cause it's like I said, dude. I want to be real. Like, I know we both feel like. Obviously, me. I mean, I've had to pay the mortgage on this property, and so I'm in negative. Sounds like you guys are in negative. The one other question I was gonna ask you. I know we've had complaints from upstairs of stealing electricity. Is that something that was just made up?
No. Hold on. So the power company. Okay, so I didn't know this, but I signed up for the winter program, I guess, on the phone. And it kind of clicked when she told me, but anyways. And so I didn't know that they'd hit me with that big of a bill. And he had just gotten an accident. He couldn't work, you know what I mean? And I'm sitting here like, oh my gosh, freaking out because I haven't worked in a while. I was in school, you know what I mean? So I'm like, oh my God, freaking out. And so then, you know, we got our stuff done and stuff, but the power is off, you know what I mean? But we asked the neighbor upstairs.
So the power downstairs is off?
Yes.
Is something broken or?
No, it's just off. The power company shut it off.
So here's what $1,100
bill. We're moving anyways, so I'm like, whatever. But the neighbor upstairs, I said, look, I'll pay half your bill if you let me plug in my fridge and my lights and, you know.
And that's what we've been rolling
with. For my
with.
Kids. And he's like, but.
So you've been paying them. It hasn't been stealing.
Yeah, no. They agreed to it. And I was like, I'll pay half your bill. He goes, no, don't worry about it. And we still throw money because that's how we are. I'm not going to, you know what I mean?
We get the groceries up there.
We don't
there.
Use very much of it. Yeah.
We do, man.
Yeah, we don't use very much of it. But anyway, so my kids aren't here most of the time, and that sucks too. You know what I mean? And then the power company refused to work with me at all. I guess Jason went in there and talked to them or something, and they accidentally turned it back on for like a day, and then they turned it off, and it was just all retarded.
Yeah.
So. Okay. Yeah, and I don't want my kids here during all that. So it's like, that's hard for me too. But so.
Okay. Well, I want to see the issues you guys have, like go look at them, understand that side of things. I guess
if you understand that we're moving, it's a crazy wreck and there's
a lot of
damage. I understand that the interview is going to end right here.
There is damage though.
Yeah.
And
the interview ends right here.
Okay. Yeah. The last question I was going to ask from your perspective, I mean, you know, we're at the portion of the eviction now where it's like,
it is what it is.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It sucks for everybody involved. If we weren't going to get the law involved at this point, what do you guys think would be truly a fair way for us to part ways?
You know, honestly, I offered Jace to patch up some, you know, holes because there is some damage, but
the holes there already?
No, well, there was a couple of them there and Jace was supposed to note that in the beginning.
Two of them weren't,
and he told
us
the night we came over here to look at it, you know, and he said the owner just kind of wants it rented out. So, you know, we're not really worried about, you know, the background check, you guys seem like decent people, whatever, you know, and I had my job calling me the whole time. But
the things with the issue of the house is that it was two holes in there, two big holes. Mm-hmm. I mean, I thought that when we moved in, that where the laundry area is at, up above, horrible. So I was figuring, if you come in and you look at it, I thought, well, okay, they're going to come in and get it done, this is that, the other, blah, blah, blah. No, the basement's been like the same thing. padding from the carpet missing from when we jumped.
And he told us it was in the storage room back there, and he never put it under, so our bookshelf was all uneven for the whole time.
So my thing is that I can do this whole job. I got pictures of my work, bro. I got portfolios. I've done million-dollar houses by myself with my own company. So when I say that I can do this,
yeah,
there's no bullshit. I own 3 houses in Cincinnati. I own 1 in Indianapolis. So when I don't pay, it's never really because of the money. Never. Just to let you know that.
Yeah.
It's because a principle stands. Because I am a homeowner. I rent. And I wouldn't rent nothing like this, bro.
Well, so, just back to your question. What do you, like, because obviously I think that's what's hard. We both, like, can agree to disagree. I don't want to do anything to hurt you guys. We both feel maltreated. And I know I've learned from the experience. I don't know if you guys feel the same, but
I'm offering to help and fix, though.
I think, at this point, though, it's not necessarily that I want the help. I just want to move forward and do things different.
Yeah.
You know? Like, I want a clean slate. I want to move forward. So, how, knowing this is the situation, how would you, if the law wasn't involved, how would be a way to just cut ties that you feel like would be fair?
I think I've been talking to this for a minute. So I think that what I told Jace was, after all my crap's moved out, I will gladly help patch up the holes and stuff, because I'll take my part, you know what I mean? Like, and we have fought a lot, we boxed a few times, like, that's love, for real, to be honest. And when, you know what I mean, and we were both, he was out of work because of his accident, and I was in school, so it was like too much time together, you know what I mean? And stuff like that. And
money, it's just been coming in for a little bit, but
and we were both
in.
Frustrated, and we were at a bad place in ourselves, you know what I mean? And so I think to part ways for me would be just like, I'll get all of our shit out, clean it out the best I can, you know what I mean? And I have shampooed the carpets, you know, when the hailstorm came, and like, it was so much damage, I was like praying I could get the carpet good, you know what I mean? But I mean, I think it would be fair. I mean, I'll still pay. It might be a slow process, so please don't sue me for that, because, you know what I mean? I'm just being raw and uncut and honest right now. You know
yeah.
what I mean? So it's like you said, it's both kind of like, it is what it is, you know what I mean? And then we got to pay to move in our place and stuff like that, you know what I mean? So if we could be like, make a deal, like, I'll pay you off within 6 months or 8 months, whatever, you know what I mean? Give me a little bit of time. I mean, that would be cool. And then I'll get it cleaned up as best I can, and then moved out, and I just need a couple more days, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. Totally. And you feel like that'd be a fair, like, if I gave you 6 months to pay back the past rent,
yeah,
if we cut our ways, you know, we'll clean up what's here, we'll take care of it, but you feel like that'd be a fair way to do things.
Do you feel like that'd be a fair way to do
things? I think for me, I mean, I just...
Be honest.
Truth be told, I never want to leave a situation where someone feels like you said, like, you're a slumlord. I don't ever want people to feel that way. I mean, this property, we put on a new roof, we put on new siding. It's nicer than a lot of the other properties. I mean, you guys are paying what, $550 a month? $500.
Well, you can get a whole house
for only $500.
No, that's not true. Well, you can get a 3-bedroom house for $750.
Mm-hmm. That is true. Yeah, that is true. But
when you're renting it as a duplex, though, it makes it. Well,
but at the same time, rent the whole f***ing house.
Yeah, well, we could do that, but then we'd have to charge more. The whole point of the basement is some people can only afford $500. Mm-hmm. Like, that's what you get for $500. You know what I mean?
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Some places you do.
Some places you do. A lot of places you don't, especially here. $500 out here, on some real shit, $500 out here is not even a studio where I'm from. You can't even get a studio for $500. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it's like, if I got a good mechanic, we might argue, we might this, but I'm not about to get rid of a good mechanic. Mm-hmm. You say you don't want to become a slumlord, then offer the help that's in front of you, bro. Check the portfolio. This, be a businessman. Mm-hmm. This is about business, right? It's about making money, right? Make some money. Okay, you didn't like me as a tenant. So the what? Yeah, I'm not your tenant no more. I'm a motherfucker that can make this look good as and get way more money out of it. So you're that motherfucking prideful?
No, not at all.
I'm not on some real shit. Are you that prideful just to say wash your hands when you have a perfectly good motherfucker in front of you with proof that can turn this motherfucker around?
He's not Jace, babe.
No, but I'm hearing what he's saying, though.
Yeah.
Well, I'm hearing what he's saying.
And that's the thing. It's no attack on you. It's just like, as you can see, the interaction's gotten to where I can tell you're upset with me.
No, I'm not upset with you. as a business person, I'm kind of upset with you.
Right. And that's the thing is, like, I don't want to do business with someone that's upset with me.
I'm upset because you're not taking advantage of an opportunity that's in front of you. That makes sense?
Yeah, it does. It does. And that's the thing, like, I mean, we do the best. It's just one of those things where, like, I've got people in place that are cheap labor.
Check them out. Portfolio,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, no,
they're not like, better than me.
Yeah,
I'd say I don't want your business. I'd say let me do the house.
Yeah,
you couldn't afford me, to be honest. Yeah. Just to be real, I bring my portfolio. You see what I've done? You couldn't really afford me, dog.
Yeah. Well, why don't we take a look at the property? You tell me what you do different, and then we can wrap things up and get out of here. And
I'll do that.
Back to your question, though, if you did that, like, I feel like that'd be fair. I know you guys hit
It'll
a tight spot where money was tight.
When we go to court on Friday, if that's still thing, I'm going to be like, hey, judge, I moved out. You
know what yeah, mean? Yeah, and that's the thing is, I don't, because that's what sucks. Every time we go to court, it costs me $200. Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? We don't have to do that Friday if we don't need to.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, if you guys could be out Thursday, mm-hmm. no court, no nothing, we're done. And if you could say, you know what, Chandler, don't be a cutthroat dude, like, you had your crap you didn't do right. We didn't pay. I can pay over 6 months.
Never even seen
how about
that?
We do this?
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'll move out of here by Wednesday. On camera. Mm-hmm. Let me do the house.
You can get this stuff done by Wednesday?
Yep. Everything will be out. I can get out. I could have been out here a couple of weeks ago.
No, we're talking about
no, I mean like get the work done by Wednesday?
Or maybe we could help the people that are
Yeah, so show me what work you would suggest doing.
The deal is.
Well, I don't know.
I'm still talking.
Okay.
My deal is. We move out here Wednesday. Give me a month. Period.
So a month to work on the
yes.
place?
We be moved out by Wednesday. I take pictures so we empty this motherfucker. Give me a month.
And then you're saying, like, just pay you to do it? Or you're saying. Okay.
Have I ever asked you to pay me anything through this whole thing?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I said, just let me do it.
Okay. Could I see what damage there is? Because if I think I could do it for $1,000.
It don't matter. I'm doing it for free the whole damn thing. I'm giving you an opportunity. That's what pisses me off about you, bro.
No,
you don't fucking listen.
Well, I'm trying to understand why would you do it for free if you're out by Wednesday if I'm letting you out by Thursday without doing it?
Because all people aren't.
You just want to make things right and get it fixed for me.
And just show you what you really can make out this motherfucker.
Yeah, and you do it for free just to prove to me that it can
If
be
I
better.
Was going
to
charge you, I would have told you my price by now.
You know, yeah. I think it's all of those reasons above that. One, we owe you. And to make it right, and because he does do really good work.
Yeah.
He can make it, I'm serious. Didn't he have two guys? You know what I mean?
Yeah,
my own crew, homie.
So the only other question I have for you, Yeah, it's mine. Could you show me what all you do?
Nope, that was the deal. I just said, that was the deal.
He does it all. Just know that.
I do everything,
we
bro.
Do
you don't need to see it. Why? If it's about to be fixed. If I got trust in my mechanic, and he said, just give me the car and it'll be fixed, and come back and come get it, guess what? I'm getting my kids my car, come back, and it's going to be running right. I ain't got no questions.
Right.
Unless it fucks up. But it won't.
Well, and I think that's the thing, though, is if your mechanic owes you $3,000, are you going to trust him for another month?
Technically speaking, I don't owe you. To be honest, if we go by the damages, whatever, we broke even, to be real. If you want to say I owe you and that makes you feel better, by all means. But take the business opportunity and be a businessman. A steady a right now. I can do it for $1,000. Well, that's $1,000 loss, waste, if you can get it done for free.
Yeah, so are you asking to live in it for that month?
I didn't ask you to live in it. I don't need to live in it.
Yeah, because I want to be able to get it rented within the next week. Like, once you guys get out, I want a crew come in, get
Then you
want to
still have this label then, right?
Because you
will. This is the lady, by the way, that bust her ass on your f***ed up step. You got that on camera?
Yeah.
Huh. These steps been like this for a year.
Yeah.
Huh. Foundations. My 18-year-old... can put a better railing up than that, bro. Your shit ain't even connected to the house. Come on, man.
What isn't connected?
Your porch. You see that separation from the wall? That's your man, bro. Your shit's f***ed, homie. Real talk.
All right.
Come down here. You got a big branch. You see that tree right there? That motherfucker comes all the way up under. Why is your bulging? because of that old right there. Now, guess what it's going to do to this in about another 2-3 years? If you don't stop it now, guess, just guess. Up, no windows, floods. Now your shit's going to be flooded. And whoever rents their shit going to be flooded. Now, on top of fixing all this shit, guess what else you got to do? Replace their shit. Why? Because at the end of the day, it's your fucking fault that they shit got fucked up. Her shit broke 3 different places because of this motherfucker right here. Imagine if she was 60 years old, 70 years old, or infant, 2 years old. Just imagine.
Yeah.
Take pride in your shit, bruh. William, you're not taking pride in this. This has not been here since the 80s. Don't nobody do this shit no more. Law abiding stance requires me this. You really need to block ones, to be real. That's what gets you to pass. This house will get checked right now, you will fail. Fail. Okay. Badly. When I say badly, badly. And when I say you really can't afford me, you really can't afford me, bro. Maybe you was on a lesson block. Huh. Maybe it was you that was going through a, 5 years, 50 properties, but don't know for real. Maybe somebody's looking over you. Huh.
Okay. Well, sir, I'm...
Okay, huh. So, yeah, you know who that be, don't you?
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. I'm not
asking you. You know who it is, don't you?
I'm not...
Do you know?
What? Do I know
who would be scolding you right now? Right now. Saying you're doing a piece of shit job, but won't tell you. Who tells you anything? Nobody.
What do you mean?
That's you're a piece of shit owner, bro. Everybody kiss your ass? No. You're a piece of shit at this. You might be marvelous at other things. You're shit at this, bro. Hire big boys to do big boys' job. You want to make money? At this rate, I give you 5, 6, 7 years. I give you another 2 or 3 years before my put your name in the dirt that say you don't take care of your property. Starting with me. You don't believe me? Look at my credentials, bro. Think I'm talking shit.
Okay.
You can get synced. Real quick.
Okay, fair enough.
So, I'm going to take the opportunity or just yourself. I can go buy it for you right now with some Vaseline, and you can go yourself right now.
All right. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be mean. Like
I'm not either. I'm just being straightforward and honest with you, bro.
Okay.
Do
it. Well,
Say deny it. Please deny it. Please say no. Please say no. Please.
What do you mean?
Just say no. So, you want to pay the $1,000. Please.
Well, sir, after the way...
Do you want to? Yes or no? Just say it. Just say it.
I don't want to work with someone that's treated me the way you have.
Oh, please, well, good. You guys, yeah. Been real with you?
No,
kiss your... Come here. So, how much you in debt for this motherfucker?
Probably $4,000 now with that situation.
No. How much are you really in? Don't play with me.
Like... $60,000, $70,000 that I still owe on the place.
And you're planning on getting out of that by doing what?
Renting
now,
it.
I don't want to help you now.
Okay.
Don't want to help you now. So, $1,000 is going to get you out of 60? You got a lot to learn, homie.
Okay. Well, so you guys are good being out by Thursday then?
I'm good being out by Friday, make you pay another $200 because you're dumb. That song, tape and record it. Oh, you couldn't play stupid with that face, huh? Don't play with me, little boy.
Well,
don't play with me. Please don't play with me.
All right. Thanks for your time, man. Have a good day. That was awesome. Let's get out of here because he's pretty heated. I'd just hop in because I don't know if they're going to. What was that?
Shaking in my legs right now. I'm just sitting behind the camera. It's out of his mind. Dude, what if they sue us, though?
What do you mean, what if they sue us?
Well, what if it goes on YouTube and it's like this big hit and stuff, and it's like they come after us or whatever?
Well, it's my property, and I made sure that they said, yes, you could use this stuff, remember?
And it was on vocally, too.
Uh-huh. Yep. So.
All
right. Woo! Are you recording?
Yeah.
That was nuts, man. So we'll try and put everything in. That was a 30-minute conversation. And I mean, you can back me up on this because we're probably we're probably going to cut it down just so it's not all there, but literally, did I say anything that should have got him to go from, like, calm and collected to, like, heated up? No. Like, I said I was super open. He, at the end, was pissed because he was saying, and this is what doesn't make any sense, he wanted to fix all of the stuff that was wrong with the property for free, for no reason. He just wanted me to say, yes, you can do it. But because I'm stupid, and he just freaking went after me for being a stupid businessman, for not letting him do the work for free, he freaked out and called me all sorts of names. And literally, how are you feeling after that?
I'm shaking, quite honestly.
You were like literally shaking when we got into the car and you were recording.
I like hobbled in the back seat. He was like, just get in the back. I like jump in the back with the tripod and basically like fall over like.
And they did, they were right though. They paid rent good for a long time. Looking back, here's the thing. That is our smallest unit. It's our cheapest unit. The truth is that unit though, is super nice for its size, like at least it was. And what's frustrating is, yes, we had one window that was broken from something that we, by the sounds of things, should have done a better job. I'm gonna talk to Jace because to my knowledge, it was covered and shouldn't have caused issues. The other thing that's crazy is they have multiple broken windows from them. They've had multiple fights that we've had the cops called. There have been drugs. There's been all the stuff we talked about earlier. So these people literally went insane once they got on drugs. And you saw at the beginning, they're like, oh, I don't wanna get Jace in trouble. Like, we don't wanna say anything negative about him. It was so weird how then he just clicked and went crazy. And Jace says, he's done that ever since we got into this. At the end, he said, screw you guys, like we're pushing it all the way out till you have to go through the eviction process. When his girlfriend, I think she could tell he was starting to escalate and she just got out of there. It's sad because we know she's gone through all kinds of crap. It's just a freaking mess. I don't know what to say other than that was just kind of insane. The thing that's hard is like they legitimately feel like it was okay that they didn't pay rent for 4 months because we were late on fixing a window or we were late on cleaning up mold in the bathroom. Here's the thing on those two things. First of all, the issues, every one of the issues they brought up was at a point where they weren't paying rent and we just wanted them out. The other thing with mold in the bathrooms, it's really hard because we have a fan in there, but if you don't turn the fan on in any bathroom, especially in these smaller units in the basement, and you're constantly doing showers or running water, you end up with mold in there. It's just something that happens. It's something that you clean up. It's not going to cause issues. It's not going to cause problems. Every rental has an issue like this if they're not doing their part of either opening a window or turning on a fan. And it's not like it's dangerous mold. Like, that's why he was upset saying, oh, we had kids, we yada yada. Jace eventually got over and got that fixed. But the thing that's crazy about it is it's something that really wasn't a big issue and it was on them. It's something you go and clean up and you're good and you make sure that you open the window. So that was the only complaint that made us sound bad and it honestly wasn't a thing. The other thing that really frustrates me is I hate being called a slumlord. That is not the way we do business. This property had very clean everything. I mean, literally, I wish I had pictures of it when we were finished because it's a very nice unit. However, it's still a unit that we're only charging $500 for. Like, it's a lower end unit. So you're not gonna expect granite countertops and this high end stuff. The other thing is so much of the stuff he said is just straight BS and you can tell he's done this with other people before. So I'm pretty wound up, that was crazy. I've had a lot of stuff where I've bashed heads on people's doors. I've had people get in my face. I feel like I kept my cool pretty well, but still there at the end when he was getting up in my face, I definitely was like, all right, we gotta go. I can tell that like the temperature was to the point where it was probably time to roll out. So I'm just like, all right, we don't wanna look inside. We don't wanna talk anymore. You go your way and we'll just do the freaking eviction process and pay whatever we have. Because even though they said they're gonna get out, I promise you, just knowing this situation, we're probably gonna have to show up with the cops, pay all this extra money, go through the whole mess of a process. And I guarantee we will never see a dime from them because no matter what we do, like they have so many people that they owe money, I'm sure it's a mess. And it just is one of those things where we should have done a better job finding tenants for that property. However, this is a property that's become a little bit of a nightmare because that bottom unit has just been hard in this neighborhood to fill with good tenants. And so we'll have to see what happens.
How did you expect that to go? Or, like, as far as what you were expecting it to be? And then, like, what did we get? How did that turn out?
So, I saw him at the court appearance, and I knew he has a very animated personality. And so I knew he would get spicy. I knew it would get fiery. However, I didn't think it would get to the point where I was so nervous. Like, I was getting spit in the face. I was getting F-bomb after F-bomb. Like, it was one of those things where it's like, man, I have not said anything. Like, I thought I would get it heated up by what I said, but I didn't say anything to get him heated up. He just lost his shiz. You know what I mean? But, oh.
Dude, it was great. I think you got what you were.
Yeah. This is the number one reason I don't manage my properties. I have 63 doors worth, and I don't manage them because literally if you pick a bad tenant, I mean, one out of 63, everyone else is paying. We're in a great situation. We've never done an eviction start to finish where we've actually had to call the cops to get people out because everyone else has just left when we threaten or once we file the paperwork. So this has been a crazy situation. I've done this for the last 5-6 years now. And so to go all the way through the process, I am so grateful that I do not manage these properties, that I don't have to deal with situations like this. Now, with that being said, you don't have crappy tenants like this all the time, but you make mistakes and you get a crappy tenant every once in a while, and it's a mess to go through. So I guess the biggest thing I would leave you with is make sure you have a management company so you're not having to deal with this, and make sure that they have their processes in order so that you have mistakes like this as little as possible, preferably not at all.
And to not go camp out in their front yard and talk to them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And don't go try and interview someone that you're literally evicting from their property, because odds of it getting heated up are probably pretty good. He was really mean to me. And we do a good job with our properties and with our tenants, but it gives you a real look at how, even though someone hasn't paid rent in forever, they feel like they're justified in doing what they're doing. Where as a landlord, it's hard because you're like, dude, I can't even get you to answer the door to freaking pay your rent. How am I supposed to come and fix the window that you broke? Yeah. That guy, even though he's crazy, has always working an angle to be able to stay in there as long as he can. He's always hoping we'll push things back or do something to let them keep control of the property. All the promises he made of fixing the stairs, fixing the stuff in the property, all the terrible things we've done, he's been saying he was gonna fix them forever. Like, he's been claiming he has all this stuff and this ability when all they've done is added holes and damage and crap to the property.
Do you think he owns 3 houses in Cincinnati?
No. No way. I mean, you're telling me you can't pay rent for 4 months and you're a landlord in 4 properties in Cincinnati? Bull crap. If you enjoyed the video, push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next time. Thanks, guys.
Boy, I'm glad you didn't get punched.
I thought I was going to get punched.
I was like, he's tall and kind of thin. I can maybe take him out by his legs and, tackle him or something. Get out of here.
I'm usually good at keeping my cool, but that was 30 minutes of high adrenaline.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
dude.
Wow.
Plunge into the utter abyss. We call it that.
That's kind of loud statement.
There's our first hole. Here's just stuff. More stuff. And more stuff. And stuff. Couch, chair, and just destroyed the sink. The cupboards broke all the cupboards out. Luckily in this video you can't smell it. But I can smell it.
Yeah.
The fridge is gonna, oh! Honestly, if you can get the stuff off, you guys can take the fridge out of here if you wanted to. And throw it away.
Oh, wow, that's hitting me now.
And in this room,
trash.
Just, they broke that light, so they're trying to jimmy it so they can get power to it somehow. I gotta fix it before we turn the power back on. This room was the bedroom. Now this room is just full of laundry. And a lot of laundry. And that's it.